Well, Bill talks about using hydroponic effect with the ponds flowing to nutrient in ponds flowing through the growing beds. But when you're talking about high energy aquaponics, you've got to put electricity energy in. You've got to have built infrastructure. You've got to have pipes. You've got to have all kinds of non-soil infrastructure. And then it goes through to a gravel growing bed or a volcanic pebble growing bed. And there's no soil creation. It's not sustainable in the end. The energy input's going to be higher than the energy output of, and that's measurable. And it's quite considerable because the lifetime of the infrastructure, which is inevitably going to fail, the input of electricity and the input of feed. And it can't just be black soldier fly larvae because it's all fat and protein and you have to add carbohydrate. So you've got to have some carbohydrate, otherwise your fish actually get liver problems. So feeding is a little bit tricky and often that's bought food. So that drops the energy order even further. So, but it's quite good food. What's grown on hydroponics, which is not good food, usually it's chemicals with hydroponics, but what's aquaponics? With aquaponics, it's literally grown on the nitrites, which become nitrates in the process of going through the gravel. And if you check the nutrient density of aquaponic food, so the food grown on the fish, the aquaponics, not hydroponics, the aquaponics, it's good nutrient density, but it's not building soil. So it's not got any interest. It's not building security. And the infrastructure's got to fail eventually. But you might not have any space. You might be stuck without any access to soil. You might be in a high rise. You might be in a city. You might be somewhere where you just don't have that availability. You can use solar power. You can use alternative power. All that has to be replaced over time as well. And if you're in an area where you have power failures, you've got to have backup of generators because you've only got 20 minutes. Because what you have to do to get this to work is you have to kind of fish farm. You have to densely stock your fish much higher than you can keep them alive without oxygen. So they're not going to last very long when the power goes off. So you've got to make sure you've got a backup power supply. So if you're running on solar originally, you've got to have a backup battery somehow to keep them alive if there is any failures. So I think it's good that people can get access to good food. I think it's good that they can get some fish of reasonable quality and some vegetables of reasonable quality. I think it gives you an understanding of the vitality you gain from high quality food. But as soon as you get to a soil media, yes, you're much more sustainable if you go for soil. I mean, you can actually get a positive carbon footprint then. You can be building more soil fertility than you can ever use, and you can increase the soil quantity and quality over time. So that's the main point. And when you see the large aquaponic systems, the very large factories, so you're going from having a lot of chickens in a small yard to having hundreds of thousands of chickens in a large factory. That's what you're doing when you go into a large aquaponic system. You go into a large fish factory instead of a small fish factory. Now you've got a lot of infrastructure, and you will notice economically they all fail over time. They very rarely pay back the cost of the infrastructure installation of the initial setup. And it's just a couple of seasons later they're starting to fail and the economy collapses. They're nice systems, but they're not really sustainable.